it is a fashion trend that is really sweeping the nation with a really powerful health message. Go red for women. Today is the 9th annual National Wear Red Day.
It is the American Heart Association's campaign to raise awareness that heart disease is the number one killer of women. Channel 4 Action News anchor Sally Wiggin has the story of a survivor who barely escaped becoming a statistic.
There were a lot of women taking control here at the American Heart Association UPMC screenings at the USX Tower. Among them, a courageous survivor with a message.
To think that it can't happen to them. You know, when you talk about heart disease, a lot of people think, oh, it's older individuals or it's men that it impacts or it's people who don't have a healthy lifestyle or don't eat right. And unfortunately, that's when it's the most shocking time.
That shock came in June 2010. While the 41-year-old banker and mother of three was exercising.
I felt this excruciating pain across my entire chest, across my entire shoulders. Thinking that I might have pulled a muscle, you know, from working out, I just thought, well, let me just lay down for a minute.
She then collapsed, and a friend at the house called 911. She was rushed to surgery, a stent placed in the torn artery in her heart.
3 months after I was in the hospital, I ran my first 5K.
Although her episode was rare, Amy is aware of the need for all women to pay attention to their bodies. And today, those women lined up for cholesterol, blood pressure, and body mass screenings.
If primary care docs would routinely check those three things and would work with their patients to try to optimize those three things, we would see a clear decline in heart disease.
Dr. Mathier's specialty is heart failure and transplants, the worst cases. And he has this sober warning.
Most people who end up with end-stage heart disease had no idea what kind of risk they faced for it, and that's especially true among women.
Now, what happened to Amy is called a coronary artery dissection. The artery down the front of the heart, called the widowmaker, tore. A blockage then caused a heart attack.
Now, does she worry? Is she concerned?
Not anymore. I mean, obviously she did for a while. You kind of wake up, you go to bed at night and think, what's going to happen? But she said she doesn't now. She just really makes sure she takes time for herself.
Right.
You know, because women have a tendency.
What's that like?
They have a tendency not to take care of themselves
right.
and to ignore warning signals.
Right.
Actually, far more than men do.
That's the takeaway here. You got to take care of you.
Absolutely.
Thanks.
There you go.